Hey EFAP, did you guys check out Sitch and Adam's show last night? They had a debate with organized chaos and actual fandom, and they said a lot of BS. They also said that you guys would not debate them. So, in case anybody was curious, we ran a policy, and it's been edited over time, as does with all policies. I think at first, when we started EFAP, it was like, welcome one and all, we will debate all. And then eventually it was like, actually, okay, we're not gonna do it with people who have mental issues of any kind. You probably know what episode this was prompted really early on. But we
Yeah.
realized, like, oh shit, okay, no, that we're going to avoid people that we think are a little unhinged. People have like hyper bad faith, people are, who are, there's a risk of something happening if they were to talk to us. So we don't do that. It was like a year or two ago that we had covered different people. We saw different things and we were like, oh, another one to add is if people are saying things about us with the deliberate intent of trying to talk to us, like that's their goal, then we're not going to entertain it. Like they have no other goal than to just try and get a step up the ladder or to try and just get to us to, to say whatever.
Yeah, some people are insanely bad faith and they only want to score points and try to get clips and stuff, and they're not interested in really having a conversation. So those people aren't really good to have discussions with because there wouldn't be a discussion. I mean, if you saw the organized chaos and talk with, was Eric July?
Look, all the power to everybody who wants to have the more memey discussions. I respect the hell out of Eric July, and of course, Adam's such a good friends of EFAP. Welcome to us or whatever they want. We really, really, really want to have discussions that are about like understanding and shit, back and forth. I feel like I don't need to justify this as true with all of the many times that we've not only had really good conversations with people we've covered, but also several of them have become contributors, so to speak, to EFAP. We've had a few that go off the rails here and there, but like that's just not at all what we're trying to do.
Yeah,
I know you
we're.
guys would find it entertaining as hell. That's just not what we're that's not our thing. I've seen clips of
Yeah, I. Some of people say it's clout farming. It's like, yeah, absolutely. Like, these people are like absolutely like the dregs of intelligence. Like, they're just not capable of having
Well, I
discussions
want this
and
to be made
stuff. It's just.
aware in isolation because I couldn't fucking believe it when I was made aware of this. Of course, they've called us all of the ists and isms under the sun, as is per usual. Apparently, the other one, not organized chaos,
Actual fandom.
he called Eric July a chunky monkey.
Hey. I cannot believe, like, what in the,
Now,
I can't
I want people
believe
to
that.
understand.
Like,
We are okay a lot of the time with some harsher, more edgy jokes. But that one, I was like, no fucking way. Because. Do you not
dude,
know?
yeah.
And
But we
then
called
when he
Weeba a
was.
clown person,
When he
so, you know.
clarified, he said, oh, no. I did that because I was trying to say he's fat. It's like a
What?
chunky.
If anything, that's worse.
You just made
That
it worse,
takes
man.
care of the that takes care of the first half, sort of.
Jesus
But
Christ.
like, jeez, oh my God.
And then he said, I Googled it. It's not related to
Googled it. They confirmed that what I said wasn't racist. Google has my back.
I was losing it, and then, as if to not make the situation even fucking funnier, he said, I have a black friend who said it's not racist.
Okay. Well, if that's the defense that is okay, then we'll make sure to bust that out whenever we need to.
Oh
Oh,
yeah, and he said he was
man.
quoting Iron Man. You cannot see this is where you can't pay for shit like that. That is something you can only get from the kind of shit that Eric and Adam and Sitch can get into, but I couldn't fucking believe it. I thought it was so hilarious. And it's so weird to be purity tested so hard by people who do shit like that. You're like, hey, hang on, isn't that like against all of your rules? But okay, it's fine. It's fine because you didn't intend anything hurtful. That, of
Well,
course,
except for
doesn't
the
apply.
chunky part, right? Like, that was intended.
Well, what I'm trying to get at is like, I thought they were against fat phobia or whatever.
Well, I mean, I don't. I.
In
They
any
don't have
What was
standards in
all
that
of that?
in any
What
case,
was
I
your.
thought their rules forbade stuff like that, to use the argument like my intention was this, so it's okay. It's like you never care about people's intentions. So what is this? Like rules for thee, not for me, I suppose. But Go check it out, I suppose, if you guys want. It's a fucking disaster, and I'm fine with they can clown themselves on all shows if they really want to. Like I said, big respect for Eric to actually put up with. He did like a 3.5 hour conversation or something. I was like, I don't know how you did that, man. Iron Man pass. And they do go to like angry blows at some point as well. I think Adam Sitch are said to be the most disgusting people they've like talked to, and that they're worse than the people calling everything woke because they go to bat and cover for those people. The Iron Pass.